there. This one I can hold. And guess what? Home Depot. Good old Rust-Oleum. Close enough. 10 feet away, nobody's gonna see. None of the old ones you had to stick the screwdriver in. That was always fun. Line up the dot to this. Give it a shaking. Do, 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 do. Don't need that anymore. Sit that right there. Come on. There we go. Let's get a little mask in this way. Looks like. There we go. Okay. Like I said, close enough. Woo! Okay. Same thing over here. Put this right here, protect that. And a little bit right here. We can clean up where we grinded that off. There we go. Now, it should be able to survive. Here. Should be able to survive a couple more years without rusting out. Mm-hmm. All right. Oh, it's just a little more right there. Yeah, we'll take it all the way back. Why not? Now we're looking good. Okay. Cover up where we grinded off so it doesn't rust out. It is steel. What does that mean? Tempo de motor. Of course, they sprocket. Goes where the sprocket is. Reason we got this, these four holes line up with the original four holes. Okay. The other nice thing is, this motor alright. Now here's the thing, this goes on top of these, it doesn't go underneath. You want to go on top. So I went ahead and I put this in a vise and I bent this back a little bit so it goes in a little bit better. Okay, next thing, I don't get too much pain on myself here. If you lift this up enough, this thing should be able to twist. Oh, yeah, I did touch it. Sham, 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 sham. Look at that. I should have waited till the paint dried. It's okay, I didn't last time. Comes off in a couple days. Okay, I don't have an angle. Look at that. Who did that? what happens. When you try and do it by yourself. Okay. Should not be hitting on anything now. See, if I pulled the brake cable out of here, it would. But I did this with the motor wire in last time. Just gave me even less room. Yeah, oh, just like that. Dun dun dun. Alright. And because the clips are not on this one, which is nice, get the wires through. Mulberry cable. There we go. You guys like each other, stay together. Bar got bent on the bottom. Yeah, it is bent. My cable doesn't want to go in as well. I gotta go warm. Room. There you go. So, as I can see, the bar on the left one that holds the tray on. How do you paint now? Oh yeah, jacket. Dang it. Well, it's a little cold. What do you want to do? Okay. So, four screws. Forward. Definitely not lined up now. There we go. That one's in. There's the other one. Okay, so guess what that means? Pounding time. Do, 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 do. Okay. That's what I want to put the wheel up for, because we don't want to smash the motor. And I found out about six times over, this thing works better. see. No fuss, no muss. Okay, it's in. None of that would make no sense whatsoever. Okay. Okay, and because I'm crazy. It's the longest wire. You know, batteries last, right? There. This one goes back here. Touch the blue paint again. And this one goes back on red. Okay. I'm going to resolve with a hammer. Right. Oh, the chain. I'm making it hard on myself. Okie dokie, let's take these off again. Come on, don't strip. Did I bend that a little? Let's fix that. Yeah. Okay. The chain. There it is. Boink. Okay, okay. Next time, don't forget to put the chain on before you put all the bolts on. These ones are soft. Get on the shirt, that's good. And that's all the check. Alright, let's get the motor wire. Okay. So blue and yellow. Have to go to black and red. And then the wheel has to spin forward. So what we're gonna do is run a test. Make sure we're putting the wheel on straight. Or the wheel goes forward. Because blue is closest to black, we'll put the black on the bottom. Okay. And the tab goes that way. And this goes like this. Stick your fingernail in there and bend the tab out a little bit more. There we go. Black on the bottom. I stick the red one at the same time, otherwise the cables are so short. Oh, it really helps. There's a click. Come on, I see you. Oh, by the way, this motor is an MX350. There it goes. And it clicks. And... that. And then we're going to be crazy and plug the power back in. Like that. And that's not good. That comes off. And I dropped it. Go on as well. Okay, power. We have power. And let's turn the wheel so the back wheel doesn't hit the table. And it's going backwards. So, I turned it off. Disconnect the power again. Oh, wow, that's gonna be pain. Disconnect this. And then we get our little screwdriver set again. Pop these out. So then we'll put the red on. It's red and blue make green, means go. Black and yellow. Who knows? Let's see. That's why you test it before you take it all apart. Put it back together again. I'm going to move on to the next step. It should be one less step process. Boom, got it. Okay. Red's going on the bottom. Let's tab that a little bit again. Kind of bends up on you. Click, it's on again. Let's try one more time. Plug it back in. Plug that back in. Get the power back on. Oops. Power's on. Uh-oh. Something's not happy. There's the black. Red's in. Okay. Okay, let's try it again. Power's on. Wheel goes forward. Power's off. Plug it again. So guess what we get unplugged now? Everything. So the control board's in there with two little screws, one there, and pop that baby out. Now you're just gonna unplug everything. That's really nice. So every one of these plugs goes in its own little spot. So there is no. Two. jam it through there. I love how the clip is through the hole now, but yet it didn't want to come. Okay. The black one loves to be on it. Okay, that's my charging point. I don't lose that. Okay, that's my controller. Those controllers, the on-off switch is not going to be working anymore, so we're going to have a key. Why is the bottom one always tighter than the top one? There we go. Voila. Controller's done. Now, I got the little door, because there's a little washer there. And we take these little thingies off. Put them on later. Well, change my mind. Done basically, because we're gonna have a 5-clip next. Pull that through there. Da 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 da. There we go. Okay. So I'm probably gonna need that, but whatever. Guys, the old grips have this tire pump in it. You're going to want to save that. Got an idea for that later. Also, need an Allen wrench again. Got to loosen the throttle control. Take that off. Well, whoever put that on there was very strong. Okay, that's loosened up. Sorry, you can't see this right now. I'm just ticking off the Allen wrench bolt that is on the throttle control. And now the Allen wrench is stuck in there. There we go. Nice. Strike. Okay. So, as we're working on the handlebars, might as well bring it up. Sorry, guys. Here we go. All right. Bugs in. So, guess what everybody says? I say get a big old Crescent wrench. Where's my cloth? And the cloth. And everybody says squirt a little WD-40 in there. It comes off real nice. Well, that's pretty good. Get it to spin around the circle. I'm hitting the brake. It starts twisting off.